So guess what? We got a booth. We got a booth at an antique mall here in Texas.
It's me.
So yes, we got an antique mall, so I'm able to put together a toy booth because I really don't have antiques. I have vintage stuff, but I don't have antiques. So my toy booth will consist of toys, vintage, early 2000s, so you know, 80s, 90s, early 2000s stuff, even some more modern stuff. Whatever I come across thrifting or at the bins or at the thrift store. We will also have, we'll probably have more vintage dishes because that's what Monique is into, and knickknacks, vintage knickknacks. So we're going to have a spot for her to sell her stuff as well. So we went over to set up the booth. Here it is. Here is our first booth. Today's Saturday, so we're gonna try to fill it up a little bit to hopefully get some sales this weekend. There's Monique. You guys haven't seen her too much. She's here today. So we're gonna get this ready to go, and then tomorrow I might bring some more stuff. So let's get this booth all set up. Finished, we put some stuff up, got some Nerf guns up, some action figures, some other miscellaneous stuff here, more action figures, some plush, and then we gotta fill up the shelf this side here. We think this side we're gonna put the stuff that Monique picks up, so like dishes and other cool little knickknacks like that over here. So be a little dish slash knickknack side, and then toys on this side, and then we're gonna see how it goes. So hopefully everything goes well with this booth, and hopefully we sell some stuff. So Monique hasn't been to the bins here yet, and I was finally able to, just got done with that rush. Check it out, hooked up Monique with all that thread right here. She likes to sew and stuff, so there was a bin that was full of thread, scissors. She said these are good. What'd you say these are for?
Thinking shears. Who? To cut the fabric so it doesn't fray.
Oh, okay. Then I got a cool Predator DVD down there somewhere. Some sewing machine parts, some buttons and stuff. I just started grabbing all that stuff. Sweet, you like it?
Yeah, I can't reach that stuff. I need help.
Oh, no, it's lost forever. What is your verdict so far?
I found too much stuff.
You found too much stuff? Yeah, we found all this. We were expecting to just pop in, she could look around, maybe pick up a couple of things, but we have a whole cart. And it's so much better when you have somebody else here with you. Oh man, they put out a whole new thing over there. I gotta go check it out. I'm gonna go check it out. See you guys later. Anybody want this giant bear? Bye. Yeah, that's cool. There we go. Here we go. Let's see if there's anything good over there. Everybody, trick-or-treating for Halloween. All right, I'll be back. Just got done with that rush. Check it out. Hooked up Monique with all that thread right here. She likes to sew and stuff, so there was a bin that was full of thread, scissors. She said these are good. What'd you say these are for?
Who? To cut the fabric so it doesn't fray.
Oh, okay. Then I got a cool Predator DVD down there somewhere. Some sewing machine parts, some buttons and stuff. I just started grabbing all that stuff. Sweet, you like it?
Yeah, I can't reach that stuff. I need help.
Oh, no, it's lost forever.
So we came back with a bunch of stuff. These are all little figures I got. I'm putting stuff like this in like a dollar bin in my booth. Got some Yoshis, some vintage, like, you know, Bambi figures, SpongeBob, you know, anything that looks fun, interesting. And I picked up some, got Rod Stewart, picked up some more stuff. I found a bunch of Thomas minis. Then I got this Five Nights at Freddy belt. It's like that seatbelt kind, and it still has a tag on it, so pick that up. I got some marbles down there, some staples. What else did I get? I don't know, little stuff in there. Oh, I got some DVDs. Sealed media. And I got this. Oh, this was cool. So I was like, oh, sweet. Love me some Predator. So got the special edition Danny Glover Predator 2. And then we got some plush. So we got this plush here. You know, a little mix of plush. Got this guy. I don't remember where this guy's from. Monique found him. And he's a big dude. It's probably on the tag, right? Let's see. Applause. This looks old. I don't know. I have to look that up. And Monique found that Nerf vest. There's some more plush. This one was cool. It's a little bear, but he has like an Amtrak outfit. So that's cool. And I got this North Carolina, like, golf sock, I think. That's what it is. Pretty sure that's what it is. And then Monique got herself some stuff here. I don't know if she wants to tell you about it. We'll see if she rolls over here and tells you what it is real quick.
This is for the booth. So this is some kind of squisher thing. I have no idea. Looks like you squish it and then, like, juice comes out of here. I got these little mini brick books. They're not that old, but... we've got Robin Hood, 101 Dalmatians, Jungle Book. I found this. This is Sirocco wood. Vintage.
And you said that's for the booth?
Yeah, that's for the booth. And then I got this purse. It has a retro like feel to it, but it's not retro. I think it's Ann Taylor. But it's pretty clean inside. I got these like little quilting squares. They're like brand new. I got two of those. I got this necklace because it's like in super good shape, and it's Kate Spade.
You found it at the bins? What? Yeah.
Then I found these retro patches. They're from 1971. Oh, yeah, that's pretty cool. Mm-hmm. So I thought, like, with all the things that are going on in fashion right now, like, you know, that kind of would be popular. I don't know. And then I found this bandana. It's made in America. So I think it's older.
Merc.
I think it's older. It's like, it feels thicker and I like the colors.
You said it has an M on it for
Yeah, it has Monique. An M on it for Monique. No, but I'm going to sell it though. Where's the M?
In the center.
It's right here. And then I got two pot holders. These were made by hand. Here's a little thing to hang them up. They're really cool. And then I found a doily for the booth. Either to sell or like to display stuff. I found a vintage Tupperware lid. I found a vintage, I think it's vintage, Little Mermaid placemat. I only found one though. And then I found another one. This is Tweety. This one's double sided. I had to clean it though.
Oh, Sylvester's on one side and Tweety.
Yeah, and Tweety. And then I found this really cool briefcase. It has like a bunch of Marine Corps like stickers on it. I think that's somebody's last name and maybe their number. I don't know. Samsonite has more stickers here. And then it opens and closes really well. So it looks like on the inside. So that was really awesome. And then I found this whole thing of recipe cards. It's Betty Crocker. There's a little stamp right there. don't know if you guys could see it. It's kind of dark. But I found these separately. Like, these were all scattered around in the bins, and I had to, like, dig them all out. These are from 1975.
Yeah, these were all scattered in one bin, and this was... They were just out of it. And then she figured, she put two and two together. Yeah. And we were like, oh, she's like, help me get these. And I was like, all right.
I think they ordered this from the mail, because there's like this whole thing about like to write in or whatever. And there's like an index, Betty Crocker, and then like this thing of coupons that's never been opened. So they're really cool. They have like pictures. Every one of them has pictures on there. Really cool. I really like this.
You're going to sell that?
Yeah, I'm going to sell that. And then a bunch of plush.
And then Ivan scored her some sweet stuff.
It's like all this thread.
I got all that thread for her.
Then I have to untangle these Singer sewing machine pieces. Probably going to sell those. I don't have a Singer. Some pins. Some buttons. A lot of these are like really retro. These ones are really pretty. I like these. I might keep those. Then I got a bunch of like zippers, some bias tape, some hem facings, lace, this that goes to a Singer machine. I think it's a button holder. I'm not sure. I haven't really looked at it too closely yet. It opens in the back here. I'm not sure yet what it is. And I got some pinking shears. These are made in Japan. Then I got these scissors. Well, I haven't found them. Scissor made in USA. It says Clean Cut, the brand. And then I found this old like staple remover. It says Bates, but it's like different type of teeth on there. I don't know what you would call them. And then I found this. This is pretty cool. It's from Target, actually.
Monique's gonna be a hip chick. She's gonna be a hip chick.
This is gonna be my...
With a fanny pack.
My fanny pack for the beans. And then I found this really cool frame. There's like nothing wrong with it. I don't know why anybody didn't pick it up. It's glass, not broken. And it's by Papyrus brand. That's a brand that usually goes for a bit more money. So I'm going to keep that probably.
So that's our little haul, nice and quick.
I brought more stuff to fill up this side of the shelves, because Monique still needs some time to get ready to price her stuff. She wants to do a little bit more research before she prices her things, so I brought some stuff to fill up. A Scorponok, some plush, Spawn, some Thomas stuff here. I got more Thomas stuff. Looks like people were going through her stuff yesterday. Brought more action figures and some loose ones right here. I got tons more to bag up and price. But looking good. Hopefully it attracts people to walk in. And I think once Monique has her dishes here, it's going to help a lot. So, looking good. Got Nerf darts, got dollar toys, just little figures that I buy. Put them for a buck here. Some die-cast cars. These little Pick Me Pops for a buck. Yeah, so, looks good. I'd walk in here. Gotta get more stuff for down there, but looking good. I love this figure. I almost kept it. Yeah, looking good though. So hopefully I'll be back towards the end of the week to check on it, and if I need to refill stuff. So hopefully it goes well. Wish us luck. This is where our booth is located, right here at Mid-City's Antique Mall. So if you're ever in the Hearst, Texas area, swing on by, check it out. Check out the whole mall. Check out the whole antique mall. Check out everybody's. There's a lot of cool stuff here. And there's also a little tea cafe. So grab yourself a little tea or a coffee or something. And check out the store. Before I end the video, I was thinking I'd share with you a couple of my recent sales on eBay. Like I said, eBay sales have slowed down for me because I was off for like a month. And I just started relisting, but then I had to remove stuff because some of that stuff I wanted to take to the new booth. So I've been kind of going through my inventory and what do I want for the booth? What am I going to list on eBay? And just kind of rearranging and fixing stuff again. But we have 8 sales this weekend, and I thought I'd share that with you. First item that sold is this vintage Snoopy mug right here. It is from 1965. It's cool because it has that like turned out lip on the edge. I don't know if you can see that. And this mug here sold for $14.99 plus padded flat rate shipping. So $8.25, I think it is, for the holidays. And I always ship my mugs using a padded flat rate. I put it in a 6x4x4 box, put that in a padded flat rate, and, you know, because I could stuff it in there, make sure it's nice and padded, and I don't have to worry about the weight going up or the price going up because of the weight. And then a few minutes, maybe like 20 minutes later, the same buyer hit me up and he said he was interested in a calculator I have. So he said if I'd be willing to take $20 free shipping for that item, since he was already paying the $8.25 for the mug. So I said, sure. So here's the calculator. It's a Hewlett-Packard, I forgot what it's called. Hewlett-Packard, some sort of special calculator. Hoping you guys could see this. Hopefully it's not too dark. But he paid $20 free shipping for that. So $20 for this and $14.99 for the mug plus the padded flat rate shipping. Next item that is going out is this little heart. It's like a potpourri, a vintage potpourri holder, made in Japan. This is an item that Monique picked, and it sold for $9.99 plus shipping. It's gonna be very light, so should be real easy to pack. Obviously, I want it to want to pack it well because it's made of ceramic or porcelain. I don't know, but yeah. So we want to make sure that's packed well, so that's gonna go in a 6x4x4 box. And then I am excited about this sale because we sold this vintage Furby. Still has the tag on it, that one as well. Only problem is that this Furby, he does not make any sounds. Like the voice moves and he moves and stuff, but makes no sound. So I think you gotta fix the speaker, and there's ways to do that. You YouTube it and it shows you how to do it, but I didn't really want to get into that. So I put it up for, how much did I sell it for? $29.99. I think I had it listed for $34.99, but I sent out an offer for $29.99 and it sold. So $29.99 plus shipping. And I'm excited about this sale because I found this Furby at the Goodwill outlets. So I paid like 40 or 50 cents for it. So that's awesome. We have another mug going out, is this 101 Dalmatians Cruella de Vil mug. Cool little mug. It's vintage, and this one sold for $9.99 plus the $8 for the padded flat rate. We got this little piece here. It is a Motu Masters of the Universe He-Man Castle Grayskull piece. It's the floor for one of the levels. It's just the piece here. So I picked up a Masters of the Universe Castle Grayskull and I gutted it, took everything apart, and I sold everything individually. Some of those items go for pretty good money. This stuff, you know, the stuff that's the stragglers, not too much. I have a couple items, but I turned that $40 investment into a $200 ROI so far, and I still have the shell. So all the little pieces have sold, not all of them. I probably have like three or four left, and I have the show. So plenty of money made on that. So if you could get a Castle Grayskull, if you could get one, you can get it pretty cheap and you can flip it, flip all the pieces to it. So I had the weapons rack, all, I guess the chair, trap door, the front door, everything, yeah, I just gutted it and I sold everything individually. But this piece sold for $5.99 and it's gonna go first class shipping. So $5.99 plus shipping for this item here. All right, remember these? Do you guys remember these? Muscle Machines, 57 Chevy. I have two of these. One of these finally sold. I paid $6 for both. One of these sold. Actually, I haven't even listed the other one because I was thinking of putting it in the booth, and I was almost gonna unlist this one and put it in the booth. But it sold today for $35 plus shipping, so that's pretty cool. Hopefully I have a box somewhere that'll fit this. All right, and the last item that sold, and I've always had fun selling plush and picking up plush. And for a while, I was like, man, I would pick it up because it was kind of, for where I was at, it was the cheaper thing to the pick up, because when I was in LA, thrift stores were a little bit more on the expensive side, but you were able to find plush pretty cheap. And then I kind of slowed down on the plush, but now that I'm going to the bins almost every day of the week, I'm finding a lot of good plush, so I've been picking it up. This is not from the bins, but I have a lot of plush back there, as you can see, so I'm kind of going through it. Again, what do I want to put in the booth? What do I want to list? That type of deal. But this Stitch never lets me down. He sold for $14.99 plus shipping. I probably paid, I think, $1.50 or $2 for this. And I love this because it goes into a pad of, not a padded flat weight, but a poly bag, and it's out the door. That's it, guys. Thanks for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to check out the links below. And if you're new to the channel and you're liking what you see, check out my other videos and be sure to subscribe. And also hit that like button. So thanks for watching again. See you on the next one.